Fantastic.
Absolutely. Very nice.
Yeah, it was great to see all over social media the graduates and their families, everyone celebrating, so much diversity and representing New York City so well.
We're lucky to have them.
Yeah,
it's good.
Very exciting.
Congratulations.
Well, it's beautiful around here. Last Saturday of 2019 turns out to be pretty splendid. Temperatures are above average. It's a little foggy to start. You might want to take some extra time. Visibility's been reduced because of this mild air at the surface creating some moisture. And so be aware of that. 46 right now in Central Park. There are some areas that are in the 30s. Teterboro is one of them. Also, Morristown's been rather cool this morning. Just 28 there. Other spots, it's a mild beginning, and that's the way we stay through the afternoon. Even tomorrow's looking above average. All right, fantastic final Saturday. Lots of sunshine as this fog burns off, and we make into the low 50s again today. Yesterday's high was 54. Now, it'll be dry most of the day tomorrow. Then the rain ramps up at night. So tricky traveling late on Sunday and during the day on Monday. We're dodging rain showers. The raindrops are all gone by the time the ball drops, but definitely going to have to be putting up with some rain to close out the weekend. Humidity 83%. West winds are at 3 miles an hour. Pressure is on the rise. The next 7 hours, we'll watch the temperatures climb into the low 50s. There's a light west-northwest wind, but mainly skies look terrific and the temperatures are going to be easy to take. So if you've got some errands, the honey-do list, maybe you're already working on getting the lights down, whatever your pleasure this Saturday, things really do look nice. By tomorrow, we get most of the day dry. By noon, clouds really thicken up, but it won't be until late at night, after 7 or 8 o'clock, that we see these showers move in. Light in the beginning, but then they become heavy in the pre-dawn hours of Monday morning. Yellow indicating some heavy downpours possible, and those continue all day on Monday. Went ahead and fast-forwarded to the end of Monday, and we could have an inch of rain on the ground between late Sunday night and late Monday night. So that'll be a soaking rain across the entire area before we get into the New Year holiday. The showers are out of here just in time for the celebrations. 52 is the high. Accurate weather calling for temperatures the upper 30s overnight, partly cloudy. And then tomorrow, we're still in the mid-40s. Rain arrives late. Took the temperatures down a couple of degrees tomorrow. I think that the clouds come in. They thicken things. The clouds thicken pretty rapidly, and then the rain arrives late. But that will limit the temperatures. Rain, then to widespread showers throughout the day on Monday. Tuesday, we dry out. We get some breezy breaks, 47 for the high. And then ringing in the new year by the middle of the week, we'll be in the mid-40s. And really dry conditions looking good on Thursday as well, 46 first few days of the new year. Look worry-free with the weather. We'll get some chances for rain late on Friday into the first weekend of 2020.
That's great. You know, we're going to party like it's 2019.
Crazy,
it's
isn't
not the
it?
Same. It's not
we
the same.
We used to say party like it's 1999, and
it's not
it seems so far away.
Yeah, because it is. It's a long time ago.
But now it's a far away.
20 years ago.
Now
I know.
It's the other way, and the song still works.
It does. Works. It does hold. It
it's
does.
So
hold.
So funny. End of a decade. All right. Call. Thanks, Amy. Cracking me up. Coming up next in sports, the final week of the NFL season. So why was it an alarming day at Jets practice? Details next.